Hello YouTube, and welcome back to another plot review video, and today we are on BazzleSmotherman's plot. So, let's take a look around. It's this really nice, icy, Nordic keep, and it looks like it leads off to a town or a city, and I've been around this once before, but not while it's been complete, and I got lost then, so this'll be quite a little exploration, I hope. So let's start with this little entrance. First off, there's an entrance, and that's great. And it's not like it's got an archway or a cave entrance. It's just a path, but what really makes it clear is these two trees, and I don't know if this is intentional or not, but these branches almost make it an arch, so it really sort of gets you in this way. And looking around, there are like two or three places maybe you could come in this plot. You know, here's another one. And there is another entrance around the corner, but I think this is like the best entrance, just sort of right on the edge here. Maybe I should have asked him where he wanted me to start, but here we go. So we come in here, and immediately we're faced with a decision. You've got a fence gate here that leads off over there, or we've got the main keep over here. So we'll go through this way first, because it looks like the shorter option. And what we're faced with. So you can see over there some other plot. I'll just try and put my render distance on tiny. There we go. Hopefully you won't be able to get distracted now. But so we've got a cellar entrance here. Very nice idea. I would go in, but you know, I can't seem to do that. Not sure why. Yeah, got a nice little cellar entrance. Maybe we'll come out that way. So you come round this house, and this looks like a little farmhouse maybe on the outskirts of the main town. And look at this. This is like a wall, and it's really crumbled and beaten down, and a well and stuff. So really, there's no need for that gate, but yet we have it because you can walk around here. So that's a nice little touch, you know. It showing a really broken down sort of, it makes the plot look aged. I'm just really surprised by this snowman right now. Okay, Evermoon's house. So Evermoon is a player on the server, and the detail inside this house hits me immediately when I walk in. The only thing I will say about it is I would prefer a room separation here, even if it was just fences or glass panes or something like that. I don't like to be able to see the entire interior when you walk in, but with the size of the house, it's not really something that you have. You don't really have the luxury of being able to block things off. Well, that's what you get for making a 3-wide house, something I don't really like to do. Upstairs, I like that he actually has a staircase. That's a good plus. A lot of people just put ladders, and I don't really like that. But this type of staircase, I mean, it's functional, but again, not really a big fan of it. I would prefer to have a full block here and then go up a stair. But again, that's down to the size. It's making compromises and stuff, I understand. But, eh. Again, I wouldn't have made a 3-wide house, so I wouldn't have this problem. Very nice little closet design. You've actually got clothes hanging in there. I might steal this idea, actually. Hanging clothes, and you've got chest of drawers and stuff. I don't know if this is for everybody, but the doors have been bugging on me. I mean, you know, it looks perfect there, and then the hinges are on the wrong side. I don't know if that's just me or if that's everybody, but, you know, I'm getting... that's a bit weird for me. What else have we got? We've got bunk beds. So we could tell this isn't really a couple. You know, bunk beds. And up here we've got some weaponry. So, you know, he's packed and ready in case this little town and village gets attacked. What I would say is, lighting wise, let me just check my brightness, because I do change it quite a lot. I like to have my brightness on 40%, because still bright enough so that you can make things out, but it is dark that the lighting does have an effect. You've got this candle over here, and you've got, it's daytime, so you've got these windows and it's quite bright in here. I wouldn't have that torch up there. I don't think that's necessary. And in here, all looks quite nice. You've got the light coming off the furnace, and you've got this fake light, and it's quite bright in here. So it actually does give off. In fact, this furnace, actually, the light makes it look like it's coming off this candle slightly. So yeah, that's all quite nice. But hang on, where's the entrance to the basement? That's an interesting thought. Oh, maybe you can't actually get to the basement inside the house. That's a nice touch. Oh, and we have an outhouse. Always good to see. Everybody needs to poop. So let's actually go in here and see what it's like down here then. In we go. Yeah, basic simple storage. Got some nice detail here with the stairs to create sort of the indent in the wall. Lots of hanging meat, dry, keeping the wood dry. Got chests. This is all pretty much your basic general stuff. Not too sure if I like this dirt block. This is being really, really picky now. You can tell that this is the floor of the house above. So I would have used, maybe put it down another block, used slabs just to give, just to hide the floor from above, because I'm not a big fan of, you know, this dirt here. I would have kept this all one material, or even two materials, like, but two versions of stone, or stone and wood, not dirt. Not a major thing, but it's just a small sort of detail, realistic element to think about. You know, you wouldn't really have dirt hanging like that, although I suppose you can in some ways, I don't know. So that's about, yeah, so okay, so we've spent a lot of time outside. We've got a lot to get through in this video, so in we go. So we come through this little portcullis here and the gatekeeper's house. I've just noticed you've also got a door here, so maybe this is bandits keep out. Why are bandits so close to this? Interesting. Yeah, so because I've just realised that door's there, maybe this is inside the plot, not outside. I think it's quite hard to actually work out. I mean, you've got all this here. We've got another entrance here to the keep. Maybe it looks like a main entrance to the keep. And this all looks like the wilderness and stuff outside, but then you've got the door to this tower outside of the keep, and that doesn't make sense to me. I mean, you can't actually get anywhere, and it is blocked off, but still, not quite sure why that is there. So we'll just have a look in here. Yep, just a little somewhere to sit while he's on duty. This is really nice, showing that the logs are being used for the fire. Really big fire. Maybe have it four blocks instead of two blocks, you know, to keep it all sort of well kept. And I don't know if this is intentional again, but where it's well walked, the snow isn't, and where it's near the fire, the snow isn't, so that's a nice little thing. And maybe this is an anvil. Oh, I like this. So he's not actually used the clean anvil, he used the damaged one, not sure which one. But you know, it shows that it's quite well used. Well, I'm not too sure what it's being used for, because this doesn't look like a forge or anything. You know, if it was a forge, you'd need some water to temper the steel. Then again, you know, you've got the weaponry around here, so maybe it could work, maybe. I thought this was just more of a general keeping people warm sort of thing. And we've got this really, really nice little simple car, and that's just, look at that. Yeah, when we come up here, and again we've got a little path going off and path going off, and we've got a little wooden plank here. What's this for? Not sure. That's why the plot needs to be bigger. And you've got a rope that sort of goes nowhere. Yeah, so this is nice, just nice general detailing, sort of showing that there is sort of a city beyond the plot, I suppose. And there actually isn't anywhere to go from here, so maybe this is an entrance again, or maybe that's a dock. Maybe you come in here and yeah, that makes a lot more sense maybe. You know, you come off the dock, you sort of go through this portcullis, and then you're sort of into the main outskirts of the city. You follow the path round here, and that'll get you into the main bit of the plot. I'm not sure, the sort of the purpose of the landscape and the planning isn't quite making sense to me right now. That's something I'm noticing. Just before we go and explore there, I'll quickly look at this, but this all looks fine. We've got a basil under the water here. And I like the mix of materials under here. It's very rocky, very dirty and gravelly. Quite realistic, I think, to this sort of terrain. Maybe mix the odd bit of dirt in here, but moss wouldn't grow because of how cold the environment is. You've got the biome-specific lily pads, and you've got packed ice and ice mixed in as well, so that's great, you know, mixing up the detail there. This mountain is full of dead deciduous trees and live evergreen trees, coniferous trees. All looks fine. That looks pretty good. And another thing about the trees is they hide the terrain quite well, so you can't tell if this terrain is actually good or bad. And by looking at it, I think this terrain looks like a pretty quick terrain job. You've got quite bulky bits in there, but maybe that's by design, I'm not sure. And I did just see some rope on here, yeah. So this is sort of like a hangman tree. Yep, and you've got the blood and you've got a skull. Brilliant. Detail. Perfect. You've got the rope and the noose for the hangman's tree. And the thing with hangman tree is you need this really elongated branch that's quite straight and quite sticks out a bit, which is what he's got. I've seen a few people do it on the server where it's sort of like just a normal looking branch. Like, you know, one of these branches and you've just got the rope hanging down. That's not realistic. This is realistic because it's quite straight and then goes up at the end. And just, yeah, just overall general detail, it's good. So, got a nice little stables. I think we're ready to go inside, and we've got a little fallen tree. Yeah, okay, so we'll go inside. I'm aware that this video is going on for quite a while, and it will be now we're getting in here. There's a lot to see. Every courtyard needs a tree. Isn't that nice? So this is sort of a courtyard entrance, I guess. That's what he's saying. We've got this sort of main gate, and then we've got a portcullis and another gate. This is a nice texture, and that is a great idea. I think I might be stealing this idea. So we've got the fence portcullis, which is quite a common normal thing, and then we've got the, which texture is this? This is a metadata texture. This is stone bricks, 98. Not sure of the colon, but this is a stone brick metadata, and it looks a bit like a chimney. See, like this here. But it's got this hole here, and it can drop down. Another one that I thought it was at first is the end table. Is it? Just try get the texture up so I can show you. You don't. No, that's an end chest. Which one is it? It's definitely it. There we go. End portal. Ugh, sorry about that, guys. Where have I just put that end portal? Four. There we go. So by doing that, maybe in the ground and putting the Eye of Ender, and then you could have that sort of work out for you. Not quite sure how that will look. Maybe he's tried that. Not too sure, but that might also be another alternative. That's great, and you know, this is quite open. You've got great atmosphere. You've got the detail here with this gap, and you've got a great mix of materials. I like the use of this 1:8 mixed in with the 4:1, I think it is. I want to say 4:1. That looks really, really nice mixed in together. So we'll go in, and we've got three different directions to go in. We'll go left first. Very dark, very cold looking because there's no light, which is great to see because a lot of people would just spam torches around here. It's deliberately left. Dark. We come down here, we've got a Fire Ablaze, we've got a gold vault. Why are the doors up closed? I want to get all the gold. So this is the prison, and that's brilliant. This is metadata of iron bars to make it look like, you know, you've got the door and then this. That's a really neat idea. Prisons look quite nice. As far as prisons go. Quite well detailed. I like that. This iron bar texture I might be stealing from my Western idea. We've got an open cell here. This cell has never been used since the creator of the gold vault. Interesting. And why is that? Oh dear. We found a secret, guys. So this is really cool. Again, it's all hidden by darkness. I mean, if we just go back to that cell a sec. Look, there's one candle here. The only thing that's giving off light, really, is this fireplace and that candle. You've got a hidden light in here, which I can't quite find. Just so you can actually see all the detail inside there. And then this area here, where the actual secret is, it's all dark, so you almost miss that lever there. So we come in, go down, let's see where this leads us to. You can start to see a bit of light through here, and a ladder up here. And we're in the gold vault. Yes, I love that. So he's shown us at the gold vault there, and that, what was the first thing I said? I said, I want to go in there. And look, we're in here. I love that. That's something I like to see in plots, is if you can see an area in the plot, you want to be able to get to that area in a plot. It's the same with games. If I'm playing on a game on like the PlayStation or something, if I can see an area, I want to be able to get to that. I constantly try and break games to get to areas. So this is something I love. I can't believe he's actually done this. This is like unbelievable detail and thought process going into this. He could have had this door open, you could have got into it, but no, he's turned it into a secret and a little thing you've got to get to. Was slightly given away by the sign, but then it also adds purpose to why that cell was open and stuff. So I love that. That's really cool. So I definitely made the right decision in turning left first. That has just put my expectations for this plot now unbelievably high. We'll go right next, and this is sort of a main hall throne room. Now the one thing I will say about this is it's quite narrow. I would have made it another block wide either side of the table, another block wide either side of the table, but maybe would be fine, but maybe that's because of the size of the plot, he's had to compromise that. But definitely this is a bit too thin in my opinion. This is quite nice that it's all the way up here, but you know, how's he gonna get behind this chair? It doesn't look like there's any space for the chair to be moved backwards. It's not like you can move the table forwards because it'll fall off. So what, does you have to like just climb over and just like, I am the king, but the detail's good. He's got his sword across his lap, he's got a drink and some food. You got a little keg there, a little private keg. Got a balcony up here, which I've not noticed until coming up here, and the curtains used as banners. That's a really nice technique, not seen before. Ceiling design, quite messy, but there is one up there, and you can see it's got a sort of structure, but you can see it's sort of being like sagged and repaired, and it's getting quite messy, and the detail in here is great. It's just the actual size of the room that I'm not happy with. So if you're wondering what to add to rooms or plots for detail, maybe someone who's reviewing you keeps saying, oh, you need to add more detail. This is detail. There's something almost everywhere. So that's really nice. Another thing I will say about this room is it's a little bit close to this entrance, and there's sort of no heavy door sort of to block the cold out, and there is also no sort of entrance back here for the king to make a quick getaway, because if he's up here and he's hosting all his guests and then somebody attacks and storms the keep, you know, they're going to come in and then he's the first person they're going to see here. Maybe that's another downside for purpose. It's a tight fit, but it works. Staircase is what he means. So, again, you know, I've just said we've been met with this, you know, you've got three different directions to go to. You go forwards by, what, less than 10 feet? And again, you've already got three entrances to go to. And it's just unbelievable. We'll go to this way first. This looks like a kitchen area. Again, this is quite nice that it's close to the main keep there, adding to the purpose, because the kitchens would be close to the main hall. The use of lighting in this plot is brilliant. Again, there's hardly any lighting. It's just the fireplace that's keeping it lit. And you've got this fake lighting with the candles. And in here, it's completely dark. You can't see anything, which is unbelievably realistic. The amount of times I see people lighting up storage areas, which would warm up the foods and stuff like that. And the thing that's great about this storage area is it's not food. It's literally storage. You know, you've got all these bits of tables and chairs stacked up upside down, and you've got the cauldron and stuff like that. So yeah, it's actual storage, not just we'll spam crates and stuff like that everywhere. I like that. Paintings, food stuff, it's all great. Come round here. Again, we've got all these little different directions to go to. Fortunately, we can't go further into this plot. Again, we've got more directions to go to. I thought this was going to be like another fireplace or something, because we have light, which is coming from under here. Yep. Hidden lighting using carpets. You might have been watching one of my videos, I'm not sure, but it's something that I've done. Okay. I was about to say, I'm not too sure about this ladder, but it's to get up onto these beds. So this must be where the slaves sleep. You've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 beds here. Sort of very basic accommodation. I like this. Again, maybe have a beam along here, even if it's just a slab, a half slab sort of beam, just to add a bit of support to the ceiling. And we've got another door, and again we've got more storage. What I will say is there's no sort of food storage that I've seen so far, and if this is sort of the kitchens, why is there not really any food storage? Maybe we're about to find that, I'm not sure. In here we've got some more sort of private accommodation. Maybe this is where the slaves hang out when they're not on duty. Again, we've got more, and this is really, really basic accommodation now. This is really nice, and I really like this. This is the glass pane texture metadata's. That's sort of separating the room. Guy warriors, girl warriors. Okay, so this is like a barracks. Why have the guys got a bigger space? That seems a bit sexist. I mean, come on. Like, what, the girls are just gonna go to bed after fighting, but the guys get to go and do all this other cool stuff? I mean, just got beds and flower pots. Very sexist. Let's just carry on exploring here. Lots of beds and stuff, and then in here, storage, weapons. So they don't trust the girls to keep the weapons. Interesting. Oh, these are helmets. I've been wondering what they are, why they were walking around. I thought it was just someone's player head, which is what it is, but helmets. That's nice. Okay, and I want to go over the... Right, you've proved this with the gold vault that you can get over there. I will get in there. See, you've got these sort of beams across here, and even here you've got the slab, and then it's not a slab, and you've got stairs, which really create some nice shapes in the ceiling. You need to use that everywhere. You've used it great in some places, but like in that very basic accommodation, it was just a flat roof. Even here you've got the log, even though it is flat with the ceiling. It's a change in texture. So you've got some nice work going on in some places, and then in others, where was it? Not there. Through here. Go right. And then here it's just sort of very basic and plain. So there's some things to work on, you know, just making sure that you don't miss the detail. I really like this. This is really... Oh, and we've got more to look at. So we come down here. This is a very steep stair basement. It's quite basic, I suppose. Quite interesting. Quite nice. And... what was I just talking about basements and lighting and stuff. You've got all your meat and stuff, and you've got hanging up there, and then you've got a torch, warming it all up, creating bacteria, blah 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 blah, all that sort of stuff. Obviously there would have been more over in this direction. I think, although you have this wall here, so it would have been a bigger area, I think you could have utilised this space a little bit more. Even just by adding a stone brick stair like this and putting a pillar in would make it look like it was sort of more sort of supported. You could have had something here. You could have had more food about, more meat, and this torch I'm really not a fan of. And because you're in a cold environment as well, you could actually get away with having ice down here, because it wouldn't be too much of a stretch for them to actually bring the ice down here to keep the food cold and store it properly. So there's more things to think about. Shelving, mushrooms. The actual detail on the walls, these sort of things, it's really great, adds to the sort of style of the build. Well, a lot of purpose sort of ideas of being left out in this build. That's something I'm seeing quite a lot, and I'm lost guys. Here we go, this is where we're going, so we can finally go off in these directions. We'll go upstairs because this should lead to the throne room, our main hall. And suddenly I realize that this staircase doesn't work. You lied to me. Oh, it does. So you've got to sort of jump up over on here to get away from this curtain banner. You come up here and it works just like he said. And again, you've got more up here. I'm just going to sort of roughly go over this now, because this is turning out to be some very basic stuff now, basically like bedroom and stuff. Although this, yep, got another. It's a very interesting bed, that. I mean, you've got to like sort of crawl to get in it. It's not really a very simple bed to get in. I've just gone round in a circle, so that's nice that there's actually a couple of ways to get around. This looks like a private sort of quarters. Want to see more of the castle? Give me Grand Builder so I can finish it. Well, if you have Grand... Ew, get out. I don't want to be sat in a toilet. What I will say about this toilet in particular is... you know, lots of people are going to come here, poo, it's going to build up and up and up, and then it's going to stay here. What you will notice in castles and keeps is that for toilets and latrines, it would sort of go at an angle like that, so it would come down, hit a wall, and then fly out the side of the castle. So just by having like a stair block here and then an open gap here, that would make it a bit more realistic. And I've just noticed that by knocking that block out, it's in the middle of bits of the keep. So this is not a good place for a toilet, logistically. We've got more stairs, even more, so we go up again, and you can see the rooms are getting a bit fancier, a bit more private. So that's all quite nice. I like this window low down here, because obviously your mind's telling you it should be here, so that's quite nice. Again, these bits just broken off here, more private tables and stuff. Down we go. So again, the detail is great, it's like almost perfect. Purpose wise there are bits of this plot that doesn't quite make sense. Come out here, so that must be where all the knights live, and then you're out here onto the battlements. Come across here to where all the bandits live apparently. You've got a bed there for people who are sleeping on duty. You shouldn't have a bed in a tower. You know, if the people are meant to be over here watching, they shouldn't be asleep. Unless it's the bandits, I suppose. Then why would bandits be so close to a castle that's clearly being well lived in? Not too sure. Again, purpose. Lots of things about purpose being left out here. I'm going to quickly try and whiz round the rest of this plot now, because we've seen an unbelievable amount already. Just see I've just seen a way around. Yep, round here, round here. You've really made good use of the... Oh, nice little statue design. Interesting. You've really made use of the space well. Like, it's all really tight corridors and you're moving around and you're coming back into the same areas over and over again. Look at that. Everywhere just sort of links together and it really adds to the realism and mesh of sort of the medieval style of everything's just sort of randomly put together and builds up over time and bits add on here and there. And what I do like is this area here. Normally in a plot, if you've got a big open interior like this, it looks bad, but it actually gives you a bit of reprieve from all the tight corridors that you're constantly walking around to get to this sort of area. And we've got a bit of a throne area here. Maybe this is an area of importance. Who knows? I just want to go back this way one more time. And we'll go right this time and then left. And we've got a bar. Very randomly placed. Doesn't quite make much sense, I don't think. And up here is sort of the main hall. So I knew we'd be able to get to this. No! Dark Warrior. Is it that? Lord Dakar and Reality, I think that is. Player heads. This is a... Wow, I don't think I've ever seen this in Minecraft before. So this is like the puppet shows. I really like the curtains here. It's brilliant. I love it. I've never seen that before in Minecraft. That's brilliant. It's great. I wouldn't have had the torch down there like that. I would have put them down a block and hid them a bit more. Or maybe put glowstone along the top or something. I wouldn't have the torch, but you could be able to see it though. But you can walk around here. Behind the scenes of the Puppet Palace. Workers only. Oh my god. Wow. Wow. Damn kids, they always ask for Dakar and Palace. We've done it a thousand times, they never stop making. I mean, look at this for detail. It's unbelievable. I saw that and I was just quite happy with actually being able to see it. But we can go back here. You've got all the costumes and stuff back here, and you've got. Whoa! Well, that's a bit scary. Well, we'll just back away. But yeah, just the fact that you can get back here, it's brilliant. I was quite happy just to sit there and look at that and marvel at it and just be like, oh, look at the detail there, that's brilliant. But, wow, just... And that's only about 3 or 4 blocks of depth there, and it's great. It really adds to the sort of just getting lost in this plot. We go up to the top of this really tall tower, and it comes out here, and we've got... This is to dump water on invaders trying to take the bar. Interesting. Although it wouldn't be water, it would be boiling hot oil, realistically. And this here is what I was talking about with the latrines, you know, where it can drop down and fly out. Although, if I just go back to the stairs, I've just noticed something. Well, does it? It's not in the stairs, that is it? If I just get through this cobweb, go down there, you can see this here. This would mean that you'd get splashback going inside the tower, which wouldn't really be very good in a defensive situation. So again, purpose. And we have a baluster, is that? Is that what it's called? It's one of the Roman ones. It's nice and it's a great design, but I don't think it fits in this situation. That's one thing I will say, but the back of this is very nice, quite well detailed. You can see all the trees have been cut down so they can see over there and everything. That's great sort of purpose and planning. I like that the trees have been kept here, so it adds detail to the edge of the plot. And we'll just go in through this entrance instead of going back through the tower. Lots of storage for weapons. Going round. Fireplace. Gambling. Seating areas. Bed. Mirror by Dark Warrior. Ooh. Interesting. Mirror. For mirrors, I suggest a item frame with a white stained glass pane in there. That's what I use. Yeah. So I'm going to have to end this video in a minute because it's gone on for far too long now. I'll just do PI and -5 5. Okay, so if you want to come and take a look around this plot and get lost in it like I have, I literally have no idea where I am right now in relation to this plot. If you do /plotme tp and it was -5 5, and that'll bring you outside of this plot. And I urge you all to come around here for inspiration on detail, atmosphere, sort of just engrossing you into the plot. One thing I will say for this roof exterior, maybe mix up, maybe not jungle wood, I'm not sure if that would work in this environment, but some dark oak definitely to sort of like frame the outskirts of this. I mean, it's realistic that it's all one material, but in Minecraft terms it does get a little bit samey and a little bit sort of too bland for Minecraft and for my tastes. But I mean, look at all this. Didn't even get to find this earlier. This is just unbelievable, the amount of thought and detail, and it is an unbelievable adventure. I could spend another half an hour going around this plot probably. Let's just check the time that I've been recording. 37 minutes. Wow. Guys. Wow. Okay. I'm going to end this video now before it gets to an hour's length. Definitely come check out this plot for yourselves in-game. It has got everything that you need in a plot. And if it's possible to get architect on a p-plot, I think this is unbelievably close. Not quite there, because you've got a few sort of purpose details, like a few like, well, why is that there? That doesn't quite make sense. You've got a few of those issues I've talked about, but it's, if architect is a rank available on a p-plot, then it's definitely close. Definitely close. If you build like this on a p-plus plot, or the p-grand plots, which you can do now, and fix a few of the purpose issues, I think this has absolutely no doubt in getting the architect rank. This is just, for me to have actually recorded for 40 minutes, I just can't even, wow, I'm speechless now. I've spoken for 40 minutes. So thank you guys for watching. I hope you've stuck with me all the way to the end. Just, yeah, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, all that fun stuff, and I'll see you guys in the next one.